Welcome to the quick hitter version of the Mike Wise Show. I'm joined by my producer, Bruce Bernstein, with reflections on the first weekend of the NBA playoffs, including Madison Square Garden hosting another young star that stole one from the Knicks. Look, I used to be the Knicks beat writer. I don't know if you knew this, back in the 90s. And then I covered the NBA column for many years for the New York Times. But that job was essentially, if the Knicks were going well, That was your job. You know, Howard Beck could tell you that too. And so you covered the Knicks a lot, and you always knew that you were going to be there, if not in June, in late May. Well, that hasn't been the case since 2013 at Madison Square Garden. That's 8 long years that franchise went without a playoff series. So essentially, even during COVID days, because they weren't invited to the bubble, their seasons were done in April, you know, and I always used to say, what's orange and green and goes golfing in May? It was the Knicks. But yesterday, a classic, an heirloom, if I will. Or is that too much?
No, I think you're on a roll. Just keep it going.
Trae Young showed he belongs. Look, I didn't see anything but the highlights, but You before we even got on, you talked about a pass that Trae Young threw that was as seamless and as strong as anything LeBron or Steph Curry could do, finding Bogdanovich for an open three. And this is, you know, and they come back on the Knicks and they win 107-105 game one at Madison Square Garden. I don't think the Hawks win the thing, but I think they could go a couple rounds. If they get by the Knicks, and you know what? I know you think two more series could go 7 games. I think the Knicks-Hawks could go 7 games.
Oh, it absolutely could go 7 games. You know, it's a 4-5 matchup. Those, generally speaking, are amongst the most evenly matched, right? I think those teams had identical records during the regular season as well, although the Knicks dominated them in their regular season games. But Sunday was a different story. I mean, you talk about Trae Young. It had to be a surreal moment for him to be, you know, given the MSG crowd this, you know, at the end. Because he said in the post-game interview with Ernie and Chuck and those guys on TNT, he said, yeah, they were talking ish to me and, you know, all that kind of stuff, some F-bombs, whatever. So it had to be sweet for him to do that. But he really, you know, the thing about Trae Young and that I think is so special, he seems like one of those guys who just has this 360-degree vision. He sees things that he shouldn't be able to see, particularly when it comes to guys trailing him, where he changes speeds just enough to get them to run into him. He gets the whistle. He goes to the line. He makes two. I don't even know who to compare that guy to, but he is special, Mike.
Yeah, I think, you know, a long time ago, and Bill Fitch, the late, great Bill Fitch, coach of the Celtics, I think won at least one of Larry Bird's titles for him, if not two.
First one.
And Bill Fitch, in an article in Sports Illustrated years ago, I was a kid, I was a teenager, I remember reading it. He called Larry Bird Kodak. And many of our younger listeners won't know this, but Kodak, you know, was the camera company, and they always, you know, and he said that he took pictures on the court like an Instamatic, and he went ka-chick, ka-chick, ka-chick. That's what taking photos used to sound and look like, and that's what Trae Young looked like he was taking pictures on the court. And here's this guy that has this tremendous peripheral vision, and like Bird, he almost knew what was happening behind him without having eyes behind his head. But it felt like there was a sensory, like an old school sensory basketball thing going on that I think, you know, some young players now today have it. I think Luka Doncic has it too. When he steps into the lane, he waits for someone behind him to come and guard him before he decides whether he's going to pull up or get him to, you know, bait him into a 3-point play. I think Trae Young's got that. It's amazing to me. Like guys with that kind of court sense and awareness at that, it's one thing to have a great jump shot. It's one thing to go to the basket fearlessly. It's another thing to have that extra level of understanding of basketball and how it works at such a young age. And Trae Young's got it.
And he also doesn't seem to be afraid of a big moment. I mean, look, he went into the Garden on Sunday. There was 15,000 fans there. I mean, that's the most fans that have been in an NBA game in, you know, what, 16 months or whatever, 15 months. Yeah. And he was like, yeah, whatever. You know, I'll get my 32. I'll get my 10. I'll get my 7. And they walked out of there with a win.
And he's only, what, 160 pounds or something? Dripping wet?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he looks
he's basically Allen Iverson without a posse. Yeah, I knew you'd giggle at that. And now we're going to get censured.
Are we allowed to say posse? I thought that was on the forbidden list of words.
Well, if it is, then you're going to edit it out. If you want to hear more from Bruce and myself, and we know you do, check out the full version of the Mike Wise Show from Pure Hoops Media. You can also see the video version of the Quick Hitter on the Pure Hoops Media YouTube channel.